Hello guys, welcome to you all in this new JavaScript useful snippet series. So in this series we are gonna basically talk about some shortcodes which is useful in your JavaScript development. So if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please go down below and subscribe it right now, so you will get notification whenever I'll upload a new episode in this series. Now let's get started. So in this episode I'm gonna talk about function called getURLParams, which will get parameters or data from query parameters of your location path or your URL of your like current page. So for that you can write functions to get data, but it seems general and you can make it like global function for it. So I made this function called getURLParams, and let me just show you what it is actually. And for that I have write just a constant and name it as getURLParams, and I'll pass an URL input in it. And in the function, first of all I'm gonna use regex to get an array of data with match function, which is like a string method. So it will give us an collection of record which is match with given prediction in your argument. So for that I use regex, which will just match with record whoever has key equal to value string in it. So it will give me a records with key value pair in a string. Or else if I don't have any matched record found, then it will just return me a empty collection. Now next step I just use that collection and apply a reduce method on it, and inside of reduce method I'll gonna first of all extract the first string before equal to, and I'll gonna store it as a key, and in pair of it I'll just use rest of character of string as a value. So for that I use slice method to get my 0 to index of equal to, whatever index of my equal to in string, then till then I'll just get a string and I'll store it as a key, and in a value of that key I'll gonna just pass a characters which are after equal to in my string. So that is the pretty much thing I have done in here. So and in return I'm gonna just return the whatever output of my reduce method will give it to me. Okay, so that's pretty much done of getURLParams. Now let's see how what is the result of it and how to use it. So for that I have just passed one URL right now with name and surname parameter. Right, so if you let me just console it in my console and store it this call into result constant so we can get output. So if you can see I have a name and a surname in object, so I can use this object wherever I wanted to use this data without any hurdle. So this is the best thing about this function. And if you don't have any query parameter in the URL, then also this function will not throw you any error or undefined or null. It will just write you a simple empty object, because in reduce method we have provided an initial value as object, so it will just pass it that initial object. Right, so this is the base thing about this URL parameters function, and this is a function you can use wherever you want to fetch data of your current path and fetch data from your any location which you have provided in the function. So thank you very much guys to watch this episode, and please hit like button if you found it informative, as well as share with your friends and colleague, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel, so I will upload a new more and more episode like this.